I represent the National Health Authority, which is in charge of implementing a very, very ambitious and flagship scheme of Government of India, which has given a totally new dimension to health insurance sector in India, that is Ayushman Bharat PMJAY. I've been asked to speak on rural insurance, but this being my specialty or where I'm in charge of this, and most of our beneficiaries are from rural families, and almost 6 crore people in India, it's almost 5% of population, before the launch of this scheme, going below poverty line only because of health expenditure. These are staggering features, and therefore this is a important scheme and a new adding a new dimension to health insurance in India. Doesn't need any description. Everybody knows that India spends one of the least spending countries as far as expenditure on health is concerned. We are right at the bottom with almost 2% of GDP from state side. Another interesting feature, after liberalization, the health burden has increased and the pattern has also changed. Earlier it was only communicable diseases. Now it is a mix of communicable and non-communicable diseases. We continue to be unfortunately leaders in this health burden. The statistics show, various studies show, that for a given condition, a poor person is less likely to seek health care compared to a rich person. This is a well-settled fact, and the reason is mostly financial. When we discuss health, we discuss three major components: primary, secondary, and tertiary. The primary health care is kept out of insurance part. It is looked after by what is known as health and wellness centers, which are coming up. And the PMJAY component looks after inpatient treatment. That is secondary and tertiary care, about which I will be talking right now. So some figures: 54 crore people, 10.7 crore families. Almost 40% of India is covered. And going by these numbers, this is the world's largest government-sponsored scheme of this kind. A cover of 5 lakh rupees per family per year is provided. A very unique feature, which is not present in many other insurance similar schemes across the world, is the portability. A patient from any part of country can go to any part of country, in spite of the fact that state governments are implementing this scheme. And family size, there is no cap. You can add members to the family after marriages or deaths or births. Sorry. So basically, PMJAY has increased the coverage of health in three dimensions. This is a very classical health cube which we talk. So more people are now covered. Financial cover has increased. And third, number of services which we provide in health facilities, it has also increased. There is still a gap, but we have tried to cover as much as possible. So very quickly, how the scheme was conceptualized. You would all notice that it's a very, very big scheme. It was conceptualized sometimes in the month of February 2018. It was announced in that budget. And Honorable Prime Minister made announcement in his Independence Day speech of 2018. And the scheme was formally launched on 23rd of September 2018. And from then, it started with 22 states and union territories, and as of now we are having 37 states and union territories on board. Recent two states which have joined are Punjab and Rajasthan, and so far we have covered almost provided inpatient care to 64 lakh people. Right now we are clocking almost one admission every 5 seconds. This should be of some interest to you. This is a, we have, how do I go back? Sorry. So this gives overall picture. Health is a state subject in constitution. So government of India cannot function bypassing the state. What we say, it's a scheme which is implemented in alliance with the states and union territories. So the flexibility of choosing model, be it insurance, it can be trust mode, or it can be a mix or hybrid model. So you can see there are certain states and union territories which have decided to go ahead in an insurance mode. The number is slightly less. Then most of the states have decided to go forward in trust mode. And then there are states, including the state of Maharashtra, where mixed mode is used. Not many companies have joined. 10 insurance companies and 10 TPAs or ISAs are on board throughout the India. It has three major pillars. The component of payer, that is National Health Authority, Government of India. The state health authority, we too contribute either reimbursement or insurance premium. The Government of India contributes 60% for most of the states and 90% for hilly and northeastern states and 100% in case of union territories. The other major component is hospital. And of course, the most important person is the beneficiary whom we try to give benefit to. And there is a dedicated nodal person in each hospital. So the typical way of settling claims, with some exceptions in some major hospitals and in some major companies, is email-based or paper-based settlement of claims. And what we did before the launch of scheme, why it was possible to escalate it to this level without in such a short period of time is because of a very, very strong IT backbone that NHA developed before the launch of the scheme. You can see it basically consists of three major pillars. The first one is beneficiary identification system, which has the database of these 54 crore people. It has some add-on functionalities. I will not go into that. The other major component is hospital empanelment module, which right now has data of almost 21,000 hospitals. And the third one, which is actually used in day-to-day operations, is PMJ transaction management system, which insurance companies are also using for settling the claims. It's a very, very complex system, but it is because of this system that we have been able to escalate the scheme in such a huge scale. Before the launching of the scheme, we defined our health benefit packages very clearly. It covers almost everything that a hospitalization requires, except organ transplantations, because cost of organ transplantation is more than 5 lakh usually. So everything else is covered in various specialties. 1393 is the total number of packages for which rates are predefined. Some flexibility is given to states to change the rates based on their local dynamics. And some incentives are also given to hospitals based on certain criteria. We have further modified these health benefit packages recently. And a more scientific classification is also now, we are planning to roll it out. It's also available on the website. You can imagine one person getting admitted every 5 seconds, and we are clearing the claims on the same pace, there are high chances of fraud and corruption. So we work on three pillars. We try to prevent them. Each and every case, there are various ways we are doing it. Each and every case requires pre-authorization. Then there are various ways of detecting it. We are using IT in a big way, and deterrence, punitive actions against hospitals and doctors if they are found to be indulging in any mischief. We are using, as I told, IT. We are in process of getting a firm on board for using artificial intelligence to have a system permanently in place to generate. We already had proof of concept in which we tried to generate triggers based on the types of disease, geography, season, age group, names of doctors, all these parameters. And we want to institutionalize this system, which should be happening in maybe a month or two maximum. To reach out to 54 crore people has been a challenge, and we have used various ways, including individual letters from the Prime Minister, more than 7 crore such letters. We send messages to each beneficiaries. Most of the states have started implementing this. Some states are yet to start. We'll be starting it. We are using call centers. Some states are using feedback letters. and we will be escalating this feedback mechanism now in coming soon. I'll just skip this. So the beneficiary is made aware of all these at each point of time. It's not working again. So as I told you, so far almost 9300 crore rupees, the treatment worth has been given to 64 lakh patients in more than almost 21,000 hospitals. And 61,000 is the number of cases which hospital from one state has treated with respect to patient from other state. And most of this treatment is being given for tertiary healthcare, which is a higher type of surgeries. And 62% of the claims, they are raised by private sector hospitals. There is often a discussion that privates, the hospital, the rates of the packages are not enough. But the figures speak that out of 64 lakh treatments worth 9,300 crores, 62% of claims are coming from private sector. We are using IT for our regular day-to-day follow-up. The most important part which is of interest to hospitals is that compared to any other government scheme, the speed of clearing of the claims is fastest. We monitor it very stringently, very regularly. Now again, we have just completed 1 year of the scheme, and first year was also a year of capacity building. So there were some issues, but most of the states now, they are increasing their capacities, getting more doctors on board, strengthening their institutions, and this will be further streamlined, and I presume this will help in getting more hospitals on board. So before the start of scheme, we had 39% of people in India covered by some way for health insurance, and now with the launch of scheme and many other state schemes which are running in alliance with PMJ, almost 72%, that's a big jump.